It's supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious.
Okay, so for our last story, Katie, who is America's truth czar? And do you pledge your allegiance to her all-knowing eye?
Yes, I think I have to at this point. Yeah, so Nina Yakovich, she's apparently a disinformation expert, and she was recently tagged to head the new Disinformation Governance Board, which is basically a government committee on disinformation that will operate out of the Department of Homeland Security, if that's reassuring.
Chairman Schiff and distinguished members of the committee, it is an honor to testify before you today on the degradation of our information ecosystem and its exploitation by malign actors. This is a threat that is dismantling democracy. As Americans right now exercise their democratic rights, it is critical the nation is informed about how disinformation might blunt their voice and their vote.
And she seems like a very interesting woman. In addition to her work, she writes these sort of glee club songs about things like misinformation and Elizabeth Warren.
Information laundering is really quite ferocious. It's when a huckster takes some lies and makes them sound precocious by saying them in Congress or a mainstream outlet. So disinformation's origins are slightly less atrocious. It's how you hide a little, hide a little lie.
She's basically the Weird Al Yankovic of progressive women.
When Rudy Giuliani shared bad intel from Ukraine, or when TikTok influencers say COVID can cause pain, they're laundering disinfo and we really should take note and not support their lies with our wallet voice or vote.
And the hilarious thing about her being named to head this department is that she's guilty of spreading disinformation herself, specifically about the Hunter Biden laptop story being Russian disinformation. And not only do I not want this woman in particular deciding what's disinformation or misinformation and what isn't, but it's as though people forget that power shifts. And it is possible that in just a couple of years, the Trump administration could have a disinformation governance board. And do I really want the Trump administration telling me what's true and what's Russian disinformation? I definitely don't. So I think that this was a political mistake on the Biden administration's part. This issue is just way more complicated. And I think that getting the government involved will not help anything.
It's funny. When I was at the Times, worked on the tech team, and I worked with a lot of the people who really started the drumbeat on this disinfo stuff and really like crafted the messaging on it, and were very gung-ho on, we have to have a truth czar in America. We have to make laws around this. And nothing to me that our media is doing right now is more foolish than this disinfo thing. It's so short-sighted about what can happen.
Right.
And the idea that it's running out of the Department of Homeland Security, the whole thing is like out of a movie.
Yeah, it's very 1984.
It really is.
We're in 1973 and 1984.
We actually are. Katie Herzog, as always, thank you so much for coming on.
Anytime, Nellie.
As always, please go to listen to Blocked and Reported. You can find it at blockedandreported.org. This has been TGIF. It's a podcast inspired by my weekly news roundup that I publish at Common Sense. Go sign up to get it every Friday. TGIF, everyone.